Charles Opkaleke, trans movie based on Nigerian Airways plane hijack. Did you hear me? Because somebody was smiling when I was saying this. All right, please, just pay attention. Play Network Studios, run by award-winning filmmaker Charles Opkaleke, has revealed that they are developing a film centered around the 1993 hijack of an Nigerian Airways plane by four teenage boys as a medium of protest against the June 12 elections. Making known the plan, Charles Opkaleke shared on his Instagram page, writing, "In line with our commitments to tell our Nigerian stories, my research and writing team at Play Network Studios have been working on an amazing storyline for a few months now that is centered around the 1993 hijack of the Nigerian Airways. The preliminary plot I have just been sent is amazing. We are still reaching out to key participants of that hijack to share with us a more in-depth account of your first-hand participation. If you're a key participant or stakeholder, or you know one, I would love for you to send me a message. Let's create magic." Just so you know, the 1993 event, which made various headlines, saw Richard Ogunderu, Kabir Adenuga, Benneth Oluwadaisi, and Kenny Razak Lawal hijacked a plane flying to Abuja from Lagos and forced its pilots to land in Niger Republic. The plan was in an attempt to force the government to hand over power to MK Abiola following the failed June 12 elections. The culprits were eventually captured and spent 9 years and 4 months in jail in Niamey, capital of Niger.
This was one wonder of Nigeria when it happened. People were like, how would you hijack a whole plane? Like, people didn't see it coming, but when it happened, they were like, okay. And this is just like bringing back history and putting it into a movie, just like the remake of Living in Bondage. But this one is a real story, something that happened in real life. So for those of you who never did history in school, you have something to learn. So now we can say, okay, you didn't do history, but there's a movie you can watch to learn. So yes, history made better.
I must applaud Play Network and Charles Opkaleke for all what they're doing. We always say it here. You've always been saying it. I've always been saying it, that we have too many Nigerian stories to bring a movie from. Not the regular Jimmy, Rita Dominic kissing, doing this, boyfriend snatch down. There are too many stories. And when I saw this particular one, like, oh, this really happened. Why didn't anybody think about
making it
into a movie? We see all of these things outside Nigeria in Hollywood, and we will applaud them. I'm mad, oh, mad. And Nigerian wants to do it. I'm just looking forward to this. Hopefully, I know we'll get it right, because it might not necessarily be shooting it in a plane. You can actually arrange a set and make it look like inside the plane. I really want to see.
If people can even have a studio that they go to, and it looks like they are actually, in private jets. So what are we talking about?
I really want to know everything that happened that day, and of course everything that happened afterwards, after the plane hijack and everything. Putting it into a movie, it would be what I would really love to see.
You took the words right out of my mouth, because of course it is what you have talked about, especially when it comes to Oscars, and they're saying that, oh, they want, and I do hope that they will put into consideration when they are doing this, you know, so many factors, so that at least we can win award, we can tell our stories and win award. So that they won't be saying that, oh, you didn't do this in your local language, or you did not do this, not so super percentage of, you know, and all that. So I think that they should put this into consideration. And as you said, in fact, that was the reason I loved the documentary, the docuseries I watched one time. You know, it was talking about the history of Nigeria, that I told you about. And I think that there should be more, especially with the fact that there is no history being learnt in school, in secondary schools. And these days, it's so embarrassing that you're talking to somebody young, and when we were young, in fact, even when it comes to music, we did not know so many people. They were dead, but we knew them. We knew their music. We knew about them because we were told, and we listened to all of these things. And those things are going into extinction. And I do not want it, because I want us to always have an identity. If our languages and everything goes into extinction, we don't even have histories. What exactly are we? Do we stand for?
I think apart from movies, they should also start shows where they tell stories about things that happened in the past. Because when we were younger, we had Tales by Moonlight. They had different shows where all they had to do was gather children, and an elderly person is telling them stories about things that happened in the past. So I look forward to this one, and with June 12 coming
soon. I didn't know there was a plane hijack until last year or last 2 years when I saw the story on social media, and I said, oh, this really happened. And for him to say he wants to put it into a movie, I'm down for this.
Yes.
Yeah, that's really amazing. This is something I look forward to.